We're speaking in this video about the overlay. That which is the reflection of our true identity, which is immeasurable, boundless. All we need to do is to relax into our home. Our home has no dimensions to it. It's dimensionless, boundless, measureless. Thus, it's everywhere and nowhere specifically. It cannot be located as a specific location. It is simply always everywhere. So our identity is not a discrete thing. It's a non-discreteness. That is why we say we see the reflection of the overlay. We say, I am that. The overlay is the effect that overlays all other effects. And this is the practice that will pull you out of troubles. It's a very simple practice, and we need to keep remembering it because it's possible to forget it. In the land of forgetfulness, it's always possible to forget. One moment we can feel lost in effects, completely lost, and then suddenly remember, no, my focus is on the effect that overlies all other effects. So whatever arises, you say this too, is overlaid by the one effect. If there's a tune in your head, you say this tune in my head is also overlaid by the one effect. This effect is overlaid by the one effect that overlays all effects. And that's where my focus, that's my aim. It takes the wind out of the sails of this world. And it's easy to practice every moment of the day. Whatever effect has your attention, you say, wait. My goal is the effect that overlays this effect. Immediate shift. Complete change of perspective. From being lost to feeling found. Feeling not so lost at all. It's as if we're in a deep dark forest and we're looking at every tree intently, trying to discern something, and then suddenly realize, wait a minute, my goal is the effect that overlays all of this. This tree, all these trees, this forest, everything. Why do I need to be looking at this tree so intently, trying to discern something? Suddenly your attention has shifted. That's the simple shift. That's the big boost. Keep repeating the big boost. That is the theme, the big boost. We need the big boost now, and this is it. Whatever effect is taking place in your attention, you just say, my aim is that which overlays this effect and all other effects seamlessly. One effect that overlays all effects. This is called the vision of oneness, the vision of Christ. Paranirvana. Equal vision. Abidance. as that one effect that overlays all other effects. It's called the self. Abide in the self. It's really a reminder of the self. Ultimately, abidance in the self takes place the real goal here is abidance with that perfect reflection of truth and reality, which is the effect that overlays all other effects and is untouched, untarnished by any of those effects. It's the peace beyond understanding. Goal. It comes about from deciding that we don't want to be prime creators. We don't want to keep on trying to be prime creator. So we decide the idea of not trying to be prime creator is what we want. And so the idea of not trying to do something in order to express that, the tryingness, that which could be used to try is there, and then it is not used. And so we can say we're not trying, you see. All this crazy existence is already here, and we can use that to express an idea of not trying. Now, this idea of not trying, it would be ridiculous on its own. Because then we'd have to manifest all sorts of effort trying, so then we can then show we're not trying. But because we chose the idea of trying to be prime creator and are manifesting this dream of constructivity and destructivity and negation, basically a dream of forgetfulness and negation, then the remedy for that is to choose the idea of not trying. And that uses everything that we have already imagined up. It just puts an overlay over it. And that shows, then that expresses not trying to be prime creator. In other words, not trying to negate anything. To be prime creator, we'd have to negate what we are. We'd have to negate reality, negate the prime creator, negate what we are. So right now we're trying to negate what we are, what reality is. We turn to not trying, all the efforts that we have been using to try and negate. Now, an overlay is there, and this overlay is simply untouched by any of these efforts, and that expresses not trying. The overlay expresses not trying. It's not trying to get rid of anything. It's not trying to get rid of any of this imagined dream scenario of negation. It simply is seamlessly, gently overlaying all of it. Not trying to get rid of any of it. Not trying to do anything about it. No need. It's simply expressing the idea of not trying to be prime creator, which means allowing everything to be as it is, including this dream. Abide in that. There is abidance in that. That meaning it has no boundaries, it has no seams, nothing to measure, you cannot measure it. Everything else has a name, it's discrete, it has boundaries, you measure it. But the overlay does not, it's endless. There's no end to it, no border, no boundary. No point where it stops. No place where it's put together. There's no parts or pieces or fragments to it. So we say abide in that, or abidance in that. That's the real goal for us. The final step is we would then choose another idea, which is not related to either one of these ideas, neither negation nor non-negation. that's beyond the scope of what we can talk about. No need to talk about that. It'll happen automatically once we have abided in that and are completely at peace with abidance in that. But our goal is to, this abidance in that, which comes from deciding at a level of spirit of cause that we don't want to be prime creator, giving up that foolish whim. Just something we did on the spur of the moment, tried to do just for the heck of it. Didn't really consider consequences at all, didn't consider that it would result in this crazy dream of forgetfulness and negation. A dream where we seem to have totally forgotten what we are, what reality is, how reality functions. A dream in which everything that arises is negated. Ceaseless negation. Some call it change, it's really negation. Whatever was prior is no more. It's gone. We are trying to develop a supreme power of negation that can cause reality to disappear. That's the mad scenario that we have here. Yet the resolution, the sovereign remedy, is very simple. Simply choose the effect that overlies all other effects. So this mad dance of negation, which is the Maya, the existent, the dream of duality, the hypothetical scenario of infinite negation taking place ceaselessly. One effect overlays all of that. Without changing or altering it in any way, doesn't need to. That's not his purpose. It's not his purpose to heal anything. It's a purpose to express not trying to negate anything. Therefore, it's perfect peace, perfect stability, perfect calm, tranquility. And we simply abide in that. That is the goal. It's the goal of this satsang. It's ultimately the goal of all satsangs, however it's expressed. It's simple, but here in this land of forgetfulness, we do forget. And when we forget, it's as if we feel like we have no idea of what to do, like completely lost. That happened to me just last couple days. And I couldn't for the life of me remember what the key was. It's as if we're standing outside a door to a beautiful home and we can't find the key to open the door to go inside. It's very frustrating. And then suddenly, here's the attitude to take. It's the attitude of you know that there is a very simple key. You know you've been working on it for a long time. You're working towards it. You know you've clarified it before many times. You know you have it within you to get this answer. So you know it's going to come. You just have to remain calm, focused, and just try to bring it back into focus. And just like that, today, suddenly, right back in focus, I said, oh my gosh, how could I forget that? It's amazing. The effect that overlays all other effects, that's what I want. And everything that was bothering me suddenly faded into like a shadow. Lost all its potency. Just like that. What was severely troubling, suddenly, but not troubling anymore. That's like a miracle. And it is the sovereign remedy because it can be turned to in every situation there is. No matter where you are, what is situation is arising, and whatever reactions you're having, whatever's going on, you can simply say, I choose the effect that overlays all of this. You're putting the key in the lock. Just like that, and it fits. And you realize, aha, I can open the door to the kingdom. And by the way, all these thoughts that are arising, those two are effects. Those are just effects. We tend to give too much importance to all these thoughts, thinking that they're causes. They're not. The thoughts that we're having that are arising from this dream of the universe, those are effects. And so the effect that overlays all other effects also overlays all these thoughts, the same way as it overlays a tree, or a house, or a road, or a world, or space, or stars. It also overlays all the thoughts, whatever they are. Thoughts are always forming in the universe as effects. Everything is ceaselessly changing, bumping into each other, going this way and that, and everything that's happening generates what we call thoughts. We pick up on those thoughts and we try to manipulate these thoughts. We think it gives us some kind of power over what's happening. But it's still, you know, entirely enmeshed in delusion, working at the level of effects. We think that the thinking we're doing is a level of cause. It's not. It's a level of effect. Cause is spirit. Spirit doesn't think. Spirit chooses. It knows. Doesn't think. Mind doesn't think. Mind expresses, presents the idea that spirit chooses. All this thinking we're doing is really just effects of the idea of trying to be prime creator. So the overlay overlays all that thinking too. So whatever one is thinking, even great thoughts, the overlay overlays everything, all effects that arise, that can ever arise. Even overlays the Buddha, overlays Jesus, overlays Ramana Maharshi, overlays anything that appears, overlays all teachings, all rituals, all dogma, all non-teachings, non-dogma, non-rituals, all disbelief, all belief, everything emotional, all emotions, all thoughts, all thinking, all reasoning, all perception, everything that's happening that we're aware of and not aware of, even overlays our awareness. Awareness too, in this universe is an effect. It's being generated from this dynamic of dualistic dynamic to register the thoughts, to make it seem like the thoughts are important. So that's all a hypothetical scenario of plausibility. But so spirit can believe that it can become prime creator. See, that all that can happen when spirit wants to be prime creator is a plausible scenario where it seems as if this is going to eventually happen, it's moving in that direction, it's going to happen, eventually it will happen. So spirit says, okay, I feel like I'm going to be prime creator soon. That's all that can ever happen, and it can never actually happen. So eventually spirit gets tired of waiting, saying, it's never happening, it's not happening, what's going on here? Begins to examine the entire situation and says, maybe this whole setup is just only going to give me these promises of plausibility, and it's never going to actually happen. And then when it sees through the whole thing, it says, it's never going to happen. So I have no choice but to give up this ridiculous idea. But for sake of continuity, here's this vast universe. For sake of continuity, spirit says, okay, I'll choose the idea of not trying to be prime creator. This will give rise to this overlay. It overlays everything that I've imagined. So it's all still there. I feel continuity. And spirit has some sense of familiarity that it calls fondness for this universe. doesn't really like it, but familiarity is some kind of comfort zone. There's some continuity to it. All the death and dying and destruction and negation. And keep in mind, one of my prime teachings is to remind you that in order for something to die, something has to be formed first, right? It's very important to see it that way. Otherwise, you'll get tricked by nature, by the bountifulness of nature, and thinking that there's something really great about it. No, all of that is necessary for all this negation to take place. It has to arise. The purpose of existence is negation, to give evidence of negation. And in order to fulfill that purpose, everything has to arise. All this bountifulness that we call nature has to arise. But it's being driven by the purpose of negation. And we try to separate it off and thinking that it's being driven by some benign force, you know, Mother Goddess or Mother Earth or Mother Nature, so to speak. No. It's being driven by the purpose of negation. So all of this has to arise so it can subside. All constructivity must take place so destructivity can take place. And the spirit can look at that destructivity and say, aha, there is a way to be prime creator. I'm seeing it the way in front of me at all times here in this universe, where something, you know, tremendous and huge and vast and multifaceted is all being worn away right before my perception. I'm seeing it all. My awareness is seeing it. I'm seeing how it's possible to destroy reality, get rid of it, so then I can be prime creator and create a new reality. That's what the bountifulness of Mother Nature is for. It's not benign at all. Everything arises so that it can die. That's the purpose of the arising in the first place. So when people here, they celebrate life, you know, what is that really? It's really what's taking place here is not life, but death. This universe is a universe of death. Keeping in mind that in order for a universe of death to arise, it has to have as an essential part of it the arising of all sorts of things that are defined as life. But it's a misdefinition, because what can die was never alive in the first place. It was never life in the first place. Life is eternal. God, the Prime Creator, created life, and everything the Prime Creator creates is eternal. It can never be touched or tarnished or brought to an end. It's all endless. So that which comes to an end was never life in the first place. It was only a symbolic imagination. These are the two true teachings. Teachings that remind us of the truth. Point us towards the sovereign remedy of the overlay. Choosing a new idea. The idea of not trying to be prime creator gives rise to the overlay. We abide in that. Abidance in that is effortless. And this abidance gives us deep, deep familiarity with what we truly are. And once that deep familiarity has set in perfectly, then the final step will simply take place effortlessly of choosing, going on and with real adventures that we were created to choose. This idea of trying to be prime creator was a very foolish whim. The mind, the servant of spirit, it has to present this idea flawlessly, which it is doing, and that's why we're so deceived. But we do have the power. Spirit cannot be deceived forever, cannot be deceived endlessly, because that's not the will of the Prime Creator. Spirit can be deceived for, you know, seemingly infinite amount of time if it chooses to, but not endlessly, because it doesn't work, and its frustration and dissatisfaction will build up. Inevitably it builds up, and spirit says, wait a minute, you know, I'm tired of waiting. This is not happening. I'm feeling all this fear, sickness and death and misery, uncertainty, confusion, despair, disappointment, disillusionment. It just doesn't seem to be working. There's something wrong, something not right here. The struggle, the great struggle, the existence always is there. Spirit gets tired of that and says, wait a minute, let me reevaluate what's going on. I want to know what's really going on. And then, of course, the mind will try to distract it. Bring in misdelay and misdistraction, misdirection. And they'll do their song and dance. The twins, misdelay and misdirection, come in and they do their song and dance, and spirit, you know, gets all uncertain, you know, and stops really focusing on knowing the truth, and forgets something even so simple as choosing the effect, the goal, the effect that overlays all other effects. So simple, one simple key that unlocks the door, that frees us from existence itself. Spirit forgets it, because misdelay and misdirection are very, very charming. The mind can be very, very charming, and has spirit going off on endless wild goose chases, getting nowhere, round and round in circles. But whenever you find yourself at any point, wherever going on, to say, my goal is to focus on the overlay, to choose the overlay, the effect that overlays everything that's taking place, no matter what the storm could be. You could be at sea and the storm could be enormous, raging, and you're in a little fishing boat and being tossed about, and it's incredible. And you say, wait a minute, my goal is the effect that overlays all these effects. That effect is perfect peace. It's completely undisturbed. That's called calming the waters, stormy waters. See, the Bible's very symbolic. Those teachings are highly symbolic, representing this overlay, vision of Christ. Christ means the anointed with oil, the one that's anointed with oil. Anointing with oil is also symbolic of this overlay. All great traditions at their heart know this is a fact, that the mind has distorted and twisted and misdirected much of these teachings, and everyone is still very confused and distracted, delayed and misdirected, confused, and is not aware of how simple it really is to simply choose a new idea. Make the goal the overlay. That's the reminder. As your mind wanders, as it certainly will, just catch that, say, don't struggle with the effect. Don't struggle with any effect. Don't try to replace it with some other effect except the overlay. To say, I choose the overlay of this effect. I choose the effect that overlays this effect and all other effects simultaneously. I choose that effect. Don't struggle. Don't judge. Don't say, this is terrible, this effect, I hate it, I need to try and get some other thought going, some other emotion going, etc. No, don't do any of that. Just say, I choose the effect that overlays this effect and all other effects. Very, very simple. And even when we're sick and suffering, say, I choose the effect that overlays this pain, this suffering, this depression. I choose the effect that overlays this depression, this tiredness, this fatigue, and the effect that overlays this and all other effects, including joy, elation, bliss, even overlays that. It's beyond bliss and joy and depression and despair. It overlays it. Overlays it equally. It's not doesn't care what it's overlaying. It simply overlays everything that arises in existence. Everything. Covers it like a soft blanket of snow. That's the simple truth. That's the simple remedy. That's what's titled salvation. That's the goal. And this is the reminder. Very great. And that's it.